here is a quick and useful video. Here is my task list. Some tasks are done, some are not done. Usually, we work on tasks which are not done. But what I want to do now is analyze the finished tasks. How do I filter on them? Well, there's a simple way. I go to current view and there is already a view called completed. Now, because those tasks are completed, their formatting by default is strikeout. I don't like that. So I go to view settings, conditional formatting. This is the formatting we are talking about, completed and red tasks. I go to font and I remove that strikeout. And now at least I can read them properly. But here is the problem. I can see the due date, but that alone is not enough. I want to know when I actually completed the task and I want to see the difference. Did I do it on time, before time, or it was delayed? So right click. These are called columns, fields technically. Right click on any field, say field chooser. You will see a lot of fields. We don't want to see frequent ones. I want to see all the fields related to tasks. Now we are already seeing due date. I want to see another field called date completed. And I just drag drop it. But I don't want to do the subtraction manually. I want this minus that. Go to field chooser again. And there is a new button. So you can actually create fields. And I'm going to call it difference, variance, whatever you want to call it. Well, type is actually, none of them is actually a formula. Yes, you can have formulas here. When you say edit, gives me a formula editor. What are we really doing? Field, task field. We want to see date completed minus due date. So if I completed before time, it will be negative. Look at these. So many functions are available right within Outlook. Most people have never noticed this, but now that you have, think about where you can use them to your advantage. And remember, all these are available, not just task folder, calendar, inbox, even contacts. So we have our diff field. Now that field will appear here. Again, I'm going to drag drop it. And now, miraculously, I'm actually getting variance of work done. So two tasks I have finished before time, one task on time, other tasks are delayed. Now monitoring this will give you an understanding of what kind of execution you're into, and that will help you improve. Remember, even delegated tasks are being shown here. And if you want to see who is the person to whom it was delegated, all that you have to do is go to the field chooser again and add the owner field. So go to all task fields and drag drop the owner field. So this is how you can do amazing task analysis right within Outlook. No copy paste, no Excel formulas, no manual work. Start using it, share it with as many people as you can, and let everyone become more efficient. Oh, by the way, I created a detailed video on how to do tasks delegation. Have a look at that as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.